Hey guys, welcome back to Wild Indian Rover. This is Deepak and here I am today to take you to the God's own country, Kerala. Yes, the home to many tea and coffee plantations, spices, backwaters, tropical climate, rocky beaches, South India's highest peak, and the list goes on. Everybody staying in South India, if ever plans for any nearby trip, then Kerala always takes the first place. And why not? Kerala has the essence that pulls you towards it. One such district in northern hills of Kerala that is visited by ample of tourists residing in the Western Ghats called Wayanad. Wayanad is home to several wildlife, enchanting waterfalls, dams, caves, etc., etc. It is a district with 3 to 4 towns in it, lies in the southern region of Deccan Plateau. The elevation of Wayanad lies in between 700 and 2100 meters from sea level. Its name is derived from Wayanadu, which means land of paddy fields. Wayanad is most respected district in Kerala because of the fact that it is believed that Stone Age civilization existed here, and the proof lies in the Edakkal caves. Wayanad is the best spot for hiking, trekking, and casual visitors. The overall visit to Wayanad can take 1 to 3 days depending on the areas you want to cover. And the best time to visit Wayanad could be any time but should be avoided in summers due to its hot and humid weather. And to experience the best of it, try to visit this place post-monsoon, that is from September to December. Nearby major cities are Mysore, which is 100 km away, Coimbatore at 200 km, and Coorg at 115 km from Wayanad. And you do not have to worry about your stay. You'll find loads of homestays, hotels, resorts in prime parts of the district. So here we covered few spots from Kalpetta town, like Phantom Rock and the viewpoint. Phantom Rock resembles a human skull and got its name from famous comic character Phantom of Marvel. There's nothing much to do here, but photographers can take shots from several angles. Once you are done, you can head towards Edakkal caves. These caves are the real example of how rich the Stone Age civilization was, and this cave lies at the height of 1200 meters from the ground. To reach the top, you need to climb around 400 steps, which covers a distance of 1 kilometer from the entrance. A nominal fee of rupees 30 for adult and rupees 20 for children is charged. It is open all days of week from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. except Monday. Also, if you are carrying any plastic bottles with you, you need to pay rupees 20 as a deposit, and authority will tag the bottle with sticker, which you will have to bring back and collect your refund. So the climb is pretty steep, but can be easily done with proper rest stops. This cave is believed to be formed by the arrows fired by Lav and Kush. Also, several relations of Indus Valley civilization has been found recently. You will notice several carvings high up on the cave walls once you are inside the cave. Cave is actually small and will not take more than 15 minutes for a complete tour. Just 10 kilometers away from here is Karapuzha Dam. This dam is built on Karapuzha River and was built to serve the purpose of irrigation. The dam and its green surroundings of landscapes gives a splendid view. It is open throughout the week from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. with an entry fee of rupees 30. It is best for long walks and also offers several activities like boating, zip lining, and few other things. You will find several kinds of rose and other floras here. Just similar to this dam and 35 kilometers away, we have another dam called as Banasura Sagar Dam, which is India's largest earthen and Asia's second largest earthen dam. Banasura Dam got its name after a demon king Banasura from Hindu epic. The dam was built for the purpose of irrigation and drinking. It is made up of huge stones, rocks, and the boulders with several layers, and hence called as earthen dam. The dam is open throughout the week from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. with an entrance fee of rupees 30 per person. This dam is quite huge in terms of area and surrounded with beautiful hills and will give you the best panoramic view. If you want to add a little thrill to your visit here, then do go for the speedboat ride, which will cost you rupees 450 for 5 people. but you will have to wait a long time in queue for your turn. And if you want to experience the best, visit this dam in the monsoons. The view of dam becomes stunning. Adding to this, there are more places like Chembra Peak, Soochipara Falls, Vythri and few others, which I will cover in my other videos. So that's all for today guys, I hope you liked it. Please do subscribe to my channel for more videos. And do not forget to carry back your own trash. Do not litter the caves and the dams. Thank you.